Today, we're going to get the most we can out of Adobe Illustrator with 7 lesser-known features that graphic designers really should know about. This is one part of a design I was soon going to look at and even make, but if I press Command or Control Y and then enter into outline mode, we can see that this is only one single vector path. And yes, I'm sure many of you out there know how to make this, and it's not actually one of the features we're talking about today. We're getting to that right now. But let's press L for the ellipse tool and hold down Shift to create a circle. Now, I'm going to apply a stroke weight of 10. Lovely, okay, so now, by pressing C for the scissors tool, let's click these two anchor points here and then press delete to remove the lower half of our circle. We're going to apply the same effect as the line in the top right corner of the screen, and to do that, we need to jump into the appearance panel. Now, instead of just clicking a new stroke, you can simply hold down the Alt Option key and then click and drag below. But we also want to increase the stroke weight by only 20 points for this new stroke, so that means it's going to be 30. Now I'm using the background color for this new stroke. Okay, now we need to hold down the Command or the Control key and click the two strokes, and then like before, just hold down the Alt Option key and duplicate them below like so. You'll probably thank me later when this shortcut saves you heaps of times in long workflows in the appearance panel. And just like before, I'm going to increase each stroke by 20 points until I end up with this shape right here. Now the really cool thing that we can do with this design, or any shape in Illustrator for that matter, starts by opening up the Pathfinder window. Now if you click the top right option, we can convert this to a compound shape. Now Illustrator is going to join together the shape because a compound shape needs an enclosed path to work. What we're about to do can work on any shape in Illustrator. Now if I duplicate the shape, things are as what you would expect. However, if we double click the shape and enter into the isolation mode, and then we copy the shape with Command or Control C, and then paste it with Command or Control V, we can see that our compound shapes unite in some form of kind of wizardry. And we can actually manipulate them in any way we want to, add multiple copies of our design, flip them, rotate them, and so on. And this is all while we only have single vector paths. Now you can click the top grey bar to enter out of isolation mode. But yeah, this process can be applied to pretty much any shape that you want in Illustrator, and you can really have some fun with this and come up with some interesting designs when using compound shapes in this way. Next up, a tip that will help you remain super organized and neat working in Adobe Illustrator. If you come up to Object, Artboards, and then rearrange all artboards, a very handy dandy window is going to appear. Now we have a setting for the left to right or up to down orientations, how many rows we want, and also the spacing between each artboards. You will likely want to move the artwork as well, but you might run into a small issue like this, where something hasn't moved with your artboard, and that's simply because it was locked. Pressing Alt Option as well as Command or Control and then 2 will unlock everything on your document, and then you should just have no worries moving stuff around. You cannot seriously deny how much neater and visually pleasing things look right now. When you have an organized space on Illustrator, you often feel more comfortable and more creative when designing stuff. Or maybe that's just me. Also, if you want to share your documents with clients, I'm pretty sure they will appreciate you being neat and organized like this. So the new version of Illustrator has a new tool, but we're going to expand on things and take it to the next level. So select your areas or your shapes and then head up to Object, Intertwine and Make. You now have access to this new lasso icon, and simply but carefully click around the areas that you want to intertwine, and if by magic, things are swapped over instantly. But let's be honest here, Adobe should have added this years, maybe a decade ago. Now that looks pretty cool, but what about this right here? And actually, this only takes a few seconds to do. All you need to do is press M for the rectangle tool and then draw a small shape here. If you have smart guides activated, things should just snap to the edges very cleanly. Now we want one side of the gradient slider to be dark, and you can choose any color really depending on your design. And the other side should be white, but however, the white should be set to 0% opacity. Make sure that the angle is correct as well, of course. But once you've made that, simply hold down the Alt Option key and click and drag to duplicate it. You only need to make one of these so you have a pair, and then you can just copy the pairs all over your design. And I think this would look pretty cool on typography and other artistic designs as well, using Adobe Illustrator. Now, I have shown this one on the channel before, but so many people don't know it exists to this day. So when we want to add text along a path, there is a handy menu box found here that we can open up and have some fun with. This thing gives you a lot more scope for adjustment and freedom when creating typography along a path. And yeah, let's just ignore that typo for a second. I'll change it later, I promise. So, this menu can dedicate where on the line the text is going to sit, which is probably the best part of this feature, really. We can also change the leading for some reason, I don't know why, flip the text, and also change the orientation to weird and wonderful layouts. And then to change the typo, because yeah, it's starting to annoy me at this point as well. Now, I would like to see some built-in method for knowing when the text is central, but instead we can pull down a guide from the rulers and do things that way. Do I like this typography design I've just made for this demo? No, not really, but let's move away from the demo and onto a trick that really helps with alignment. So today's video is sponsored by Milanote. Now, I've been a firm advocate of Milanote for 3 years. And if you've been subscribed to my channel for a while, you will know that Milanote is a bit different to traditional software. Now, it's more like working on the wall, so to speak, in a creative studio. It allows you to map out your projects, collect all of your ideas and inspiration in one convenient place, and it also allows you to collaborate with your colleagues or your clients in real time. So I've been using Milanote for the past 3 years to keep my creative projects organized, and this awesome tool is available for free with no time limit. So, if you haven't done already, sign up for free using the link in the description box below and start to streamline your graphic design workflow today. When selecting objects to align, we can press another click on the focal point or the object of interest, and that's going to align other objects to that thing. For example, I want these horizontally aligned, but to use the middle shape as a point of reference. If I align these two shapes vertically, they kind of shift. But maybe I just want the lower shape to remain exactly where it is. So then I just simply click it again to ensure it's highlighted and thicker and bolder. We can also do things like aligning the top three shapes in accordance to the very top height of the diamond design in the middle, or maybe even the bottom line of it. There's something else that's pretty cool with the new version of Adobe Illustrator. And that is that Adobe have given us a bunch of free templates. Now, you can find them here, and there are some interesting things to look at. However, I will say that for a company as large as Adobe, they could have made a better logo design template. Logo templates are not something I personally think are a good thing anyway. But yeah, maybe you can find some useful things lurking around in the recesses of the Adobe template section. Now, let me know in the comment section below if you have learned something today, because I sure hope you did. But whoa, wait there. If you want to continue to geek out on Adobe Illustrator content, just click the video on the screen. And until next time, guys, design your future today. Peace.